Hollywood has made a fortune from fictional stories about UFOs and creatures from another planet.
Ah, but what about the real stories? Those people who say they really have had contact with an unidentified flying object. Well, in part two of a series on UFOs, correspondent Boyd Mattson introduces us to some people who are convinced that their close encounters are anything but make-believe.
You're really not convinced that these things do exist until you see something yourself. Then it becomes more than a game. It becomes a reality.
Say it's only a paper moon sailing over a cardboard sea. But it wouldn't be make-believe if you believed in me. Yes, it's only a canvas sky hanging over a muslin tree. But it wouldn't be make-believe if you believed in me.
Imagination, fueled by Hollywood, or chance encounters with UFOs? If you think these alien spacecraft smudging up the skies in a few photos are never seen by more than one or two crazies in the middle of nowhere, go to the Hudson River Valley in New York.
The object that I saw was at least the size of a football field. There were about 20 or 30 more lights in the back, red, blue, greens, beautiful colors. It looked like a Christmas tree in the sky.
Since 1982, more than 7,000 sightings have been reported of this V-shaped craft with a circle of lights moving across the night sky. There are witnesses of unimpeachable character, like Dennis Sant, deputy clerk, Putnam County, New York. He spotted the UFO coming home from church one evening with his four kids.
We all came out over here at the road. We looked up at I-84, and we saw this huge object just hovering over the truck in kind of a shape of an L with all lights, like a city of lights.
I was a little scared because I didn't know what it was really like.
I thought that little creatures would come out of it and do stuff to us.
Afterward, you know, when I went to bed that night, I barely slept. I got up many times opening my window just to see if it was out there, if it'd come back.
I thought I probably couldn't tell this to anyone because no one would believe me, because I wouldn't believe it if someone had told me before.
But there was no keeping it quiet, especially after another family shot this home video tape. Skeptical investigators say all the sighters had been tricked.
What it consists of is about half a dozen daredevil private pilots who do this for kicks periodically. They take off at night. They form into a sort of a boomerang or V-shaped formation. On radio signal, they click their microphone, let's say, twice, and everybody turns on their landing lights.
It didn't look like an airplane to me. I'm familiar with airplanes. I was an aircraft mechanic in the Air Force for 3.5 years. Planes, when they fly in formation, I don't care how tight they are, they have a tendency to move up and down, in and out, so forth and so on. These lights never wavered. They stayed exactly even as it was one object and made the slow turn.
Mention you've seen a UFO and millions will defend you. But tell people you were abducted by space aliens and they're likely to call for the white coats.
They came into the house in the middle of the night and they physically took me out of the house. With me being paralyzed and having a confused memory of it the next morning.
What he eventually remembered, Whitley Strieber put into a book, Communion. It became a bestseller. A movie will be released this fall. Both accounts also tell of his son's abduction.
Worst dream you ever had?
It wasn't a dream.
Next thing I knew, I was in a room where they put a kind of a helmet over my eyes and shined a light on me. Then they wheeled me into another room and left me for a while.
At any point, did these aliens talk to you?
Yeah, well, only thing they really said was, don't worry, we won't hurt you. You know, don't be scared, because I was screaming.
I am sufficiently confident that there are no aliens abducting Earthlings. I will pay $10,000 cash to each and every authentic victim of UFO abduction, providing the victim reports it to the Federal Bureau of Investigation.
I am absolutely convinced that I came into contact with somebody else. I wouldn't say if I know who they are, where they're from, what they are, but one thing I know about them for sure, they ain't like me. They're somebody very different.
Next week, Boyd talks to some UFO siders who themselves are a little out of this world.